Hey guys, welcome to Music Weekly on Nights.com TV. My name is Henry Igwe. This is your favorite music roundup show. This week we have stuff from Don Jazzy, Yemi Alade, Iyanya, Davido, the DNA Twins, and pretty much all of the usual suspects. So this last week, David was involved in yet another baby mama drama after a certain newspaper brand reported that he got a young lady in a battle pregnant. 26-year-old lady reached out to the singer saying she was pregnant following their affair in 2013, but he denied it. So I think this is the time for David to get an endorsement deal from maybe a condom brand or something, so they remind him of the need to play safe. Chocolate City singer Victor Akimani talked about wanting to leave the label. She spoke out via Instagram, and from her body language, it's clear that the label hasn't given her enough support in recent times. We kind of substantiate that. But she dropped her last album, Safari, in December 2016, and she spoke about the fact that she's had to push her career all alone. And this comes against the backdrop of several other exits from the label. Recorded was Jesse, Ice Prince, Brimo, and I mean, it's just so funny. We hope to get that sorted out in due time. A new Maven record artist, Iyanya, talked about how his breakup with Ghanaian movie star Yvonne Nelson came about. He said he was just a hustler then, after he put out Pukere and he was beginning to get steam, that he had to do 4 shows on certain days to get maybe $2 million, and he just didn't have time for that affair. Yvonne was flying from Ghana to Nigeria, but he didn't have time for her because he was hustling. So he says he's single now because his career comes first. Iyanya, with all of stuff we see about you on Instagram, are you really sure you're single? Well, we kind of say, I wouldn't know for a fact. I'm a guy, man, I don't play that way, so it's fine, whatever it is. Yemi already talks about plans to go on tour in America and Canada, and Yemi has had pretty much an interesting career. You know, she's one of Africa's biggest artists, one of the biggest female artists at the moment, back to back MTV Mama, best female. I mean, I think that's really laudable for her to push her craft into a bigger demographic and more mainstream audience. So we wish her all the best with that one. This last week, the Lagos State government put out reports that their plans to place bans on live music performances at public places like bars, restaurants and pubs and all of that. And this is really a setback for underground artists. They need to create a new shift in terms of view of performances. And we hope to get along with that because, there have been an array of stars that we discovered from the streets. This sure poses a little bit of threat to their creativity and their being discovered. Don Jazzy and the DNA Twins visited the Big Brother Nigeria house in South Africa this last week and shared some words of motivations with the housemates. It was a fun outing. After time was exhausted in the house, Jazzy didn't want to leave. When the beeper went for him to leave, even the housemates were clamoring for him to stay some more, and he stayed some more, shared some good time with the fans, with the housemates. Yeah, of course, their fans gave them some words of encouragement, and it was just a thrill to see him in the house there. This last week, Idris Abdulkarim also made the news. He called out several popping artists at the moment. These new age stars from Wizkid to Olamide, Davido, and all of them. Don Jazzy specifically, saying that they fought battles in times past for this industry to be what it is today. That they created a path, they helped pave this way for these artists to get paid today. Endorsement deals and all of that. He said they need to respect veterans like him who helped put the industry where it is. And then he also talked about Two-Face Idibia, how he's been disrespectful to another veteran, Daddy Shoki. We don't know what transpired, but Idris has been controversial over time, and he says that there was supposed to be a studio session between Two-Face and Daddy Shoki, and Two-Face probably failed to come through or was late. Whatever, we hope they sort out their issues, differences, and move on. Two-Face Idibia also celebrated his 4th wedding anniversary with his wife Annie Idibia. They've been together for 18 years. 18 years is what it takes for you to do 3 law courses and maybe 2 medical courses, 4 accounting courses, and maybe 2 years internship here and there. It's ironic how she stuck by him all through, because Two-Face has a very checkered history, pretty much unstable history with women, baby mama dramas, several lovers, you know, it's just. But Two-Face is Two-Face. He's really the king, so yeah, we're happy for him. Finally, he's had a good time with his wife. He has a stable home. They have kids together, despite the other babies from several baby mamas. And we're pretty much happy for them. We hope that other couples can take a cue from this and learn to manage their affairs, whatever the hurdles, try to scale them, try to be together, if nothing for the kids at least. So wrapping up, we present to you our song and video for the week. We're actually feeling Hold On by Ayanya, produced by Don Jazzy, released in March. But our song of the week is If from Davido, which was produced by Tekle Pula in February. That's an awesome song, and it's topping pretty much every playlist and chart countdown, whatever, radio show, video countdown out there, buzzing on the internet, and we really love that one. Then for the video of the week, we're feeling Baby Boy by Fouls, produced by Clarence Peters. But what we really have for the week is YOLO by Sheishi, produced by Major Labi of GM Fame. An impressive material out there, and it was shot in South Africa, and we really love that. So yeah, this was another interesting episode of Music Weekly, Nice.com TV. My name is Henry Igwe. Thank you all for watching. Drop us comments, subscribe to this YouTube channel, follow us across every social media platform, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. We're active 24/7, 365, you already know. Thank you all.
Welcome to Fallsville Luxury Hotel. At Fallsville Luxury Hotel, we offer excellent service. Our rooms have all the necessary facilities to make your stay comfortable and memorable. You will also have access to internet service, breakfast, 24-hour power supply, full air condition, free international calls, free tire pumping service, and free car battery charging. So what are you waiting for? Quickly visit Fallsville Luxury Hotel. We are located as number 1 Adeline Rabamishile off Raja Rasaki Road, 1st Estate, Amuwo, Odofife, Stark Lagos. For more information or reservation, please call us on 080-75-78-7135 or 080-99-90-0601. You can also take advantage of our online ongoing promo at www.fallsvillehotel.com to make your reservation and payment for your favorite room, which attracts a discount rate. Please note, rooms are reserved based on first come, first serve. Fallsville Luxury Hotel, experience the home of comfort. They come home.